It's well in hand. Structurally, the car is basically done. What we're working on is the interior finishes.
Great.
There you go. That's right.
Can I ask you a question?
Sure. Don, because you've been kind of in the front line of doing this restoration, you've probably had a unique opportunity to think about the car and how it was used and what life was like. And because we are all about authenticity and that window into our history, do you have any things that you've come to understand about what life was like that you
actually quite a few. First off, people were shorter. The seats on that thing are narrow. Back in the 1800s, people weren't as wide, and they typically weren't as tall either. To ride in that car, if you want to put two people per seat, you better have a 32-inch waist or smaller, and probably more like a 28-inch waist. Lengthwise, if you're going to lay in the bunks, you better be under 5'10". Otherwise, you're not going to fit. They actually had two people
bunking with.
And the other thing is, it's a tourist sleeper, which directly equates to third class. And if you wanted, there are wood benches. These are wood seats. The entire interior is red oak, clear finished red oak. It's going to be a beautiful car inside. But as far as comfort, if you brought your own bedroll, we probably are going to seriously need to think about putting some cushions in the car for people to ride in, because quite honestly, they're not going to be very comfortable if they don't. Back like in the old days when they had those little foam pads, for the rider boxes, we're going to probably need to think something along that order with this car when we use it. It was a very utilitarian car. I mean, it was beautifully finished inside. But it was, you're talking wood benches and wood bunks, and which people brought their own bedrolls. We're talking 1889.
Is that the date that you're using to restore
it? Yes, we are restoring it back to as built 1889 by Pullman.
And you have some good pictures of that.
Yes, we have two good photos of it, and we have some of the drawings, original drawings from it. We have one builder's interior photo of it taken by the builder before it left Detroit. It was built by Pullman in Detroit. And in the exterior, we have a sister car. They built 10 of these cars. We don't have, we don't have 470. I think it's 470, I forget, whatever. It's one of the other 470 numbers for the exterior.
Is that still in existence?
No, they only, four. As far as I know, no. There is a car similar to it up in Colorado Railroad Museum, and an earlier version, an 1870s vintage tourist sleeper, is in Durango. It's part of the museum, the DNS Museum. But I'm not sure of the answer to that one.
So in terms of educational value, I'm sure all of us, or at least most of us who are rail fans, think of Pullman and we think, wow, that was really the class end of end of the business. This will be a shock.
Mm-hmm.
And yes. I think that's really valuable, because sure. Ultimately, it's one thing to look at one of the steamships and think about all the wonderful things that you see in the movies and so forth, but this is really the way people got around.
This was a tourist sleeper, or another term, immigrant sleeper. I mean, this is what the immigrants and people were coming across, they got off the ship in New York or wherever, got on a train, and they came out west. And this is the kind of cars that they came out west on.
And you surprised me by saying they were only 10 of these built?
Of that class.
Okay.
This was built in 1889. It was in service till around by the DNRG till around 1900. It was sold to a railroad up in the Boulder area who ran it, I believe, as a tourist sleeper for a while. Then it was eventually sold off to the Western Union, turned into a work car. During the Depression, they abandoned it in the Gunnison area, at which point the DNRG took it back over and used it into the early 50s as a cook car. Unfortunately, as a result of that cook car part, they had an ice box in it, but they didn't drain it correctly. And it rotted out part of one of our outer sills, so we had to, half of one of the outer sills we had to replace because of that.
Right.
Interesting. Great. Thank you.
John, thanks for
Thanks, John. Yeah. Appreciate it.